Is it possible that certain foods could help a child recover from autism? In 2006, one-year-old Ethan Fox was diagnosed with autism. Looking for answers, his parents came across research from Dr. Kenneth Bach that they say changed their son's life. And joining us now is Ethan's mother, Tracy Fox, six-year-old Ethan Fox, and Dr. Kenneth Bach, autism specialist and author of Healing the New Childhood Epidemics. Welcome to all of you. Tracy, I want to start with you. So at about 18 months, you sensed that something was wrong with Ethan. You noticed some changes, particularly with his sleeping. What did you start to see?
Ethan was not sleeping more than 2 hours a day, and not even in a row. He would run around the house just silent, but running and not eating, and would sleep from exhaustion for 20 minutes and then wake up and run again.
Even at nighttime, he wasn't sleeping through the night. So your life became basically a living hell. And you went online and you found the research of Dr. Bach, part of which recommends dietary changes for children with autism. So you first eliminated dairy. And what did you find?
When we eliminated the dairy and the wheat, within 3 days he slept through the night. It was truly a miracle. He had not slept for 20 months in a row, yet alone to sleep for an entire night. And ever since then, he never had a problem.
That's remarkable. So, Dr. Bach, obviously it's very hard for some people to understand this connection. You eliminate dairy and wheat from your diet, and suddenly you don't see signs of autism. What is the connection? Explain
that. There's a major gut-brain connection in autism that I think is under-recognized. And actually, there are certain things that can come from the diet that can actually affect the brain. And without giving a behavioral medicine, you can take gluten, which is the protein in grains like wheat, barley, rye, and less extent oats, and casein, which is the protein in dairy. You take it out of the diet, and sometimes you see these kids, they lose the glaze, they lose the fog, they stop their stimming, and actually they sometimes say their first word. It can be actually very profound.
You have a five-pronged program, basically, to helping children recover, you say, from autism. One of the first things that you say is to decrease pesticides and exposures to chemicals. How can parents do that? They're everywhere.
Well, you can't get away from it, but you can decrease it by trying to go a little more organic. We say try to stay away from the chemicals. Another thing that people can do is when you're going to microwave, don't microwave in plastic. That way you don't get the heat releasing the plasticizers into the food. So there's a couple of, and organic, as best you can. I know it's more expensive, but if you can, stay away from the pesticides and all the things that are put into fast foods and more junky food.
Sure, and of course you recommend using organic cleaning products as well,
yes,
because there's so many
much.
Chemicals in those. Ethan, I know this is exciting being here on television. How have you been feeling lately?
Good.
Tracy, tell us about what Ethan is like in school now since you've changed his diet and tried to eliminate some of the chemicals.
Ethan is amazing. He's in a regular first grade class. He has no more of the ABA and other services that he had. He's at the top of his class. He has a 97 average. And virtually no one knows that he was ever diagnosed because he's indistinguishable from the other children.
Dr. Bach, can this work for all children with autism?
No, firstly, we never say all children. We improve probably the vast majority of kids, and more are recovering or reversing autism, which is really exciting. But we don't use the word cure. We talk more about reversing and recovering kids as best we can. But I think it's important to recognize there's no one size fits all. Don't go on the internet and think, oh, this helped this kid, this is definitely going to help my child. But exploring these medical options, dietary, supplements, detoxification, can really, really be helpful and can bring a lot of improvement to many kids.
Because so many parents obviously are so desperate. We've heard stories like yours echoed throughout the whole community.